पुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बाजरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेद विभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। सहना भवतु सहनौ भुनक्तु वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। ब्रह्माण विधाति पूर्वं वेदाश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तगुम्खदेवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुक्षुर्वै शरणं हं प्रपद्ये। शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। श्रीचिद्घनगणेशाय नमो। मह्यं सुखं नित्यं स्वप्रकाशं व्यापकं नामरूपिणो अधिष्ठानं बुद्धिबोध्यं बुद्धिर्पारं सर्ववेदान्तवेद्यं प्रत्यक्परं तदेव निश्चिताब्धिः। टिप्पण सो तादात्म्य संबंध इज एक्सप्लेन बिकॉज ऑफ डिफरेंस इन द डेफिनेशन ऑफ तादात्म्य संबंध बिटवीन पूर्व एंड उत्तर मीमांसक। सिद्धांति says first that there is bheda, kevala bheda between pada and padartha, karana and karya. So all the pairs that we have seen, there are actually six pairs, but four have been mentioned there particularly. In those cases there is bheda rupa sambandha and still there is no dosha as pointed out by the purvapakshi purvamimamsaka, because we have something called as samarthya shakti which rests in karana or in pada ityadi, thereby particular connections are possible, so we don't have those doshas. However, the real siddhanta is that there is anirvachaniya tadatmya sambandha, that is kalpita bheda sahita vastava bheda, and this is established in the tippana. I have been mentioning this, but then the difference is clearly mentioned in the tippana. Kevala bheda stale tadatmya na sambhavati. If kevala bheda is there, then tadatmya is not possible. Why? Tadatmya is identification, which means abheda. So kevala bheda is there, then abheda is not possible even in pratiti. So kevala bheda stale tadatmya na sambhavati yataha abheda jnana visheshyeva tadatmyam iti vyapadeshah. When do you say there is tadatmya sambandha? When there is identification. And identification means when you cannot differentiate between the two. Thereby kevala bheda is not possible. Abheda also is obvious there in such a place where tadatmya sambandha is there. So abheda jnana visheya, when there is abheda jnana visheya, only with regard to that there can be the usage of the word tadatmya. Tasmat kevala bheda dashayam abheda pratitir na syat. You cannot have abheda pratiti if there is kevala bheda. Ataha tadatmya sambandhe abheda apeksha api asti. There is abheda apeksha also wherever you have tadatmya sambandha. Api cha kevala abheda stale sambandho na syat. On the flip side, if you say kevala abheda is there, only abheda is there, then there cannot be sambandha at all, because sambandha is between two. You cannot have sambandha with yourself. Dvayoho padarthayor eva sambandha sambhavat swasvarupena swasya sambandha asambhavaccha. Tasmat sambandha samanye bheda apeksha asti. So whenever you say sambandha is possible, bheda is expected. When you say tadatmya is there, then abheda is expected. Tadatmyasya sambandha sambandha rupatvad bheda apeksha asti. So there is an abheda apeksha and bheda apeksha. Itham bheda bhedo vina tadatmya sambandho na ghateta. Bheda bhedayo samanadikaranyam tu ekatra viruddham. Bheda and abheda both are expected. However, they cannot be together. Why? There is virodha, contradiction. Thereby, Purva Pakshi, who establishes the requirement of Veda and Abheda and ends up assuming both, ends up in a contradiction. So his conclusion is wrong. His analysis is okay, but his conclusion is erroneous. Whereas Siddhanti Uttaramimamsa steps in and says that Tathapi Kalpita Bheda Vishishta Vastava Abhedasya Tadatmimiti Nama. We say you have misunderstood this Tadatmya as Bheda Sahita Abheda. It is Kalpita Bheda. Whereas Vastava Abheda is there. Thereby Kalpita Bheda Vishishta Vastava Abhedasya Tadatmimiti Nama. We define Tadatmya, we refine the same Bheda Sahita Abheda by qualifying the Bheda as well as Abheda. We add Visheshanas, thereby making Tadatmya very clear and without any contradiction also. Mule Bheda Bheda Vilakshanam Tadatmyamiti Uktasya Ayam Abhiprayaha. And when Anirvachaniya has been mentioned, Anirvachaniya Tadatmya Sambandha. In the Mula, what was said? Ittham Bheda Abheda Vilakshana Anirvachaniya Tadatmya Sambandha. Whereas the Tippana says Kalpita Bheda Sahita Vasta Abheda. So Bheda Vilakshana, Abheda Vilakshana and Bheda Abheda Vilakshana is the definition of Mithya. We have used it many times across texts. We see it everywhere. However, what is the idea there? Says the Tippanakara that Mule Bheda Bheda Vilakshanam Tadatmyam Iti Uktasya Ayam Abhipraya. This is the idea. Wherever you see Mithya word use it, Anirvachaniya or Bheda Vilakshana, Abheda Vilakshana, and thereby to resolve the contradiction, although we don't need to say, if someone comes up with Bheda Sahita Abheda, we say no, it is Bheda Abheda Vilakshana also. Otherwise, Bheda Vilakshana Abheda Vilakshana is sufficient. Nobody expects Bheda Sahita Abheda at all, generally. Bheda Vilakshana Mityanena Vastava Bheda Abhavaha Abhimataha. What is meant by saying Bheda Vilakshana is there is no Vastava Bheda. So Kalpita Bheda is possible. Tena Kalpita Bheda Vishishtam Iti Bodhyate. So even while saying Bheda Vilakshana, it is being said there is no real Bheda. Meaning there is Kalpita Bheda. So definition wise, whatever word you use, you land in the same meaning as Kalpita Bheda Asti, Vastavika Bheda Nasti. Abheda Vilakshanam Ityanena Kalpita Bheda Bhavaha Abhimataha. And when you say Abheda Vilakshana, we say Kalpita Abheda Bhavaha. This Abheda is not Kalpita. Meaning Abheda is Vastava. Tena Vastava Abheda Avedithaha. So when people say no, your Abheda is Kalpita, we say no, Abheda is not Kalpita. Thereby, Vastava Abheda and Kalpita Bheda. Evancha Siddhante Kalpita Bheda Vishishta Vastava Abheda Tadatmya Sambandha Ityuchyate. Whether you say Bheda Vilakshana, Abheda Vilakshana, it will mean Kalpita Bheda Sahita Vastava Abheda. That is Tadatmya definition. Amumeva Anirvachaniya Tadatmya Sambandham Vadanti. And people say this itself is Tadatmya Sambandha, which is Anirvachaniya. Okay, so much for the Teppana. Then, back to the Mula, Shakya Lakshanam. 438 Avarta says Shakya Lakshanam. We have seen Shakyartha. Shakti, sorry, we have seen Shakti. Now we are looking at Shakya. What is the definition of Shakya? Shakya Lakshanam. Lakshana Jnane Shakyartha Jnanam Upayujyate. Shakya Sambandhasya Lakshana Swarupatvat. Shakyartha Jnanam Antara Shakya Sambandha Rupa Lakshana Jnanam Nasambhavati. Now Shakti reveals the Shakyartha. Shakti is Samarthya, which is Sambandha Rupa Samarthya, which rests in the Padartha. Now this Shakyartha in the case of Tattvamasi has to be analyzed. However, Lakshana is used when Shakyartha does not lead to Bodha. Where the meaning, direct meaning, does not seem possible, there you have to use implied meaning called as lakshana. Now lakshana jnane shakyartha jnanam upayujyate. You cannot just land on implied meaning without knowing the direct meaning. Direct meaning has to be understood. Only then you can see the sambandha and take an indirection from the direct meaning. You cannot just jump to anything and everything. It should be something connected. We saw some examples, we'll see more. Shakya sambandhasya lakshana swarupatva. Because we have seen samarthya is the shakti. When you are giving up that samarthya shakti, which is itself in the form of padapadartha sambandha, then you have to take some other sambandha. Sambandha with what? It should have some sambandha with the shakyartha itself. Some sambandha should be there. Ataha shakyasya lakshanam uchyate. Now the shakya, you have to understand the lakshana. Yasmin pade yasya arthasya avabodhana shakti rasti tasya padasya so artha shakya iti bodhya. So pada has shakti and the padartha jnanotpatti samarthya is there in the pada. So yasmin pade yasya arthasya avabodhana shakti. Jnanotpatti shakti avabodhana is to make you know that kind of shakti is there when you hear the pada. Shabda, when you hear, there is some shakti in that shabda which is revealed, which is going to reveal the padartha. Tasya padasya saha artha shakya iti bodhya. That is the shakyartha or the shakya. That padartha. Shakyartha eva vachyartha iti, abhideyartha iti, mukhyartha iti cha uchyate. What are the other synonyms for shakyartha? Shakyaha, shakyartha, padartha, vachyartha, abhidheyartha, mukhyartha, primary meaning, direct meaning, all these are ways to say the same thing. Tadyatha agni riti pade vanni rupartha avabodhakatva shakti rasti. We have seen this many times. Agni shabda tells you about the agni or the vanni padartha because it has that kind of samarthya, sambandha rupa, which is called as shakti. Tasmad agnipadasya vannihi shakyartha. So agnipada, what is the shakyartha of the agnipada? It is shakya or shakyartha is vanni, the fire. Vachyartha, abhideyartha, mukhyartha bhavati. Other synonyms are also mentioned. Vachyartha bodhakam padam vachakam ityuchyate. Vachaka is the agnipada. Vachyartha, mukhyartha, abhideyartha, shakyartha, padartha is vannihi. Lakshanayaha lakshyarthasya cha samanya lakshanam. Now, lakshana and lakshyartha, we have to know generally. What is the definition? We have seen shakti and shakyartha. Or shakyaha. Now, lakshana and lakshya or lakshyartha have to be understood. Through definition, vachyartha sambandha lakshanayaha swarupa bhutam lakshanam. So vachyartha sambandha, it should have some sambandha with the vachyartha. That is called as a lakshana. Lakshanaya swarupa bhutam lakshanam. Lakshanam is definition of lakshana, the indirect meaning. So indirect meaning should have sambandha with the direct meaning. That is swarupa. Very swarupa of lakshana, the indirect meaning. Yo artha padasya shaktya na buddhyate kintu lakshanaya buddhyate sa lakshyartha ityuchyate. And that meaning which cannot be known by the padashakti, or whatever is revealed, that meaning is not the direct meaning. That is through lakshana, that is called as lakshyartha. In other words, the meaning landed upon by implication of sambandha with the shakyartha is called as lakshyartha. And that indirection is through lakshana, through some sambandha with the shakyartha. Jahad ajahad bhagatyag lakshana nam lakshanam. Now general definition of lakshana has been given, lakshyartha also. Now we have to know which are the three different types of lakshanas, which is where the Shishya asks the question, before you tell me which is applicable, which lakshana is applicable in the case of Mahavakya, Tattvamasi, kindly tell me what is it? General definition of Lakshana. Thereby, Shakti Lakshana, Shakyartha, all this have been analyzed and we have landed on Lakshana. Jahati Lakshana, Ajahati Lakshana, Jahati Ajahati Lakshana or Bhagatyaga Lakshana, these are the three types of Lakshanas. So, Jahati Lakshana is giving up. When something is given up, Vachyartham Samagram Parityajya. So, when the entire meaning, not something, the entire meaning of the Shakyartha is given up, Vachyartha. The entire Vachyartha is dropped. Tatsambandhi Matram Yatra Pratiyate Tatra Jahal Lakshana. So, dropping the entire direct meaning and picking up something related to that, that is called as Jahati Lakshana. Example, we know Gangayam Goshaha Gangayam Gramha Tadyatha Gangayam Gramha Iti Kaschid Abravit. Somebody says there is a village on Ganga. The direct meaning of Ganga is the river, flowing water. On that river there cannot be a village. So the obvious meaning is the banks, not Ganga itself. So the meaning Ganga has to be completely given up. And the meaning of the banks is taken in its place. The bank is having sambandha with the Ganga Shabda. So, Padartha. So, Shakyartha Ganga, direct meaning Ganga, which is a river, has sambandha with the banks. The meaning of the banks is taken by dropping the meaning of Ganga completely. Tatra Ganga Padasya Tire Jahati Lakshana. So, the banks of the or Ganga Tira is the implied meaning. By implication, what is meant? On the Ganga means on the banks of Ganga. So you have dropped the Ganga Padartha completely, Shakyartha, and taken Tira as the Artha. Ganga Padasya Vachyartha Ganga Nadi Pravaha Pravahe cha Grama Sthitir Na Sambhavati Tasmat Pravaha Rupam Vachyartham Samagram Vihaya तीरे गंगा पदस्य जहल लक्षण वाच्यार्थ संबंध से लक्षण इति नाम दिस वाच्यार्थ संबंध गंगा बीइंग दी प्रवाह रूप गंगा नदी दैट मीनिंग इज ऑब्वियसली नॉट एप्लीकेबल एज इट इज सो यू हैव टू ड्रॉप दैट मीनिंग कंप्लीटली सो दैट प्रवाह रूपम वाच्यार्थम समग्रम विहाय हाउएवर वाच्यार्थ संबंध से लक्षण इति नाम व्हाट इज दिस लक्षण दि that we have taken. Vachyartha Sambandha. Tira has Sambandha with Vachyartha. Nadi, Pravaha, Rupa, Ganga. So, Gangayam Gramaha Ityatra Gangapada Vachyartha Bhuta Pravahasya Tirena Saha Sanyoga Sambandha Asti. There is a Sanyoga Sambandha. There are different types of Sambandhas. Sanyoga Sambandha, Samavaya Sambandha, Asamavaya Sambandha. So there are different types of sambandhas which are there between two padarthas or dravyas. Now Ganga pada vachyartha bhuta pravaha and tira, which is the meaning we are taking, whereas direct meaning is the vachyartha of Ganga pada, the direct meaning is pravaha, nadi pravaha, that flowing water, flowing river has some sambandha with tira. What is that sambandha? Sanyoga sambandha. So some sambandha has to be known. Only then you can take a different implied meaning. So what is implied is tira through this lakshana called as sanyoga sambandha between Ganga padavachyartha and tira, which is lakshartha. So that sambandha, sanyoga sambandha, saiva lakshana. अत्र वाच्यस्य समग्रतया परित्यक्तत्वात् जहल लक्षण यम. दिस इज कॉल्ड अ जहल लक्षण. व्हाई? बिकॉज एवरी पार्ट, नॉट अ पार्ट रियली, समग्रतया एंटायरली द मीनिंग हैज बीन ड्रॉप. इफ एट ऑल देर आर पार्ट्स, ऑल पार्ट्स आर ड्रॉप इन द वाच्यार्थ. दिस लॉन्ग टिप्पण, आई जस्ट गो थ्रू दिस, आई जस्ट मेंशन एन ओवरव्यू. Simpler examples are used, or rather examples are revealed with a story. the examples reveal the meaning through a story. There is, you know, these direct examples which are very well known. Instead of that, some story is used there, and thereby these examples, at least the Tippanakara thinks that they are helpful and they are simpler. So I'll just go through it for completion, and I'll explain only parts, otherwise it is kind of clear. Ja lakshanayaha lalitam idam udaharanam. So it is a lalitam udaharanam as per, you know, it's simpler to understand as per the Tippanakara. Yasya jamatu pita pravasi sa jamata shwashuragruham vivahartam pitru vyadi bandhuvi sa jagama tatra nutana vastra paridhapana kale jamatu pita vastrena alankriyatam iti kashchana ah. So some setup of marriage where the son-in-law's father is yet to reach, and some marriage ceremonies are going on, or rather he is traveling and he is not there, has gone out or whatever. Now the issue is that somebody says, you know, on this occasion you dress up the groom's father. So kashchana etad vakyastha pitrushabdasya shakyartho yaha jamatuhur janakaha satatra asannihita iti vakta janati. The one who is uttering the statement, you know, you dress up the groom's father, it is not limited to the father alone. The groom's side, whoever is there, should be dressed up. Now, if the father isn't there, who should be dressed up? The guy who says it, he knows that the father isn't there, then the uncle is dressed up. So the meaning of the uncle is through some sambandha with the father who has been uttered. So the shabda, pitru shabda, is the vachyartha, whereas lakshyartha is the pitru sahodara, the brother of that father who was mentioned now. So this is the jahati lakshana. Ataha, so vakta ataha etad vakya gata pitru shabdena jamatru janaka rupa mukhyartha bodhane vaktus tatparyam nasti. So you have to understand tatparya there. If the fellow knows that the groom's father isn't there, why would he say father? He did not mean father at all. Not limited to the word father at all. It has an implied meaning. So tatparya is not there. If you know the tatparya, then you know that the uncle is to be dressed up as well. Tasmat pitru shabdena shakyartha bhuta janakam samagrataya vihaya janaka sambandhi pitru sahodara pitruvyaha graya ityasmin vakye pitru shabdasya jahati lakshana. So jahati lakshana has been used, and the story is showing that it need not be one example, gangayam goshaha, gangayam gramaha, which we may not have heard maybe. But these kind of scenarios also are there where we regularly use lakshana without even thinking that we have used lakshana. Implied meaning is landed upon because in behavior, in society, this is how it is. You don't have to analyze how this word connects with the meaning. How these words have ended up meaning differently also, that is through lakshana. It is very common, please. Implied meaning is very common where direct meaning makes no sense. Or it is always a implied meaning because direct meaning is not in the tatparya at all. So when we use it commonly, what is the issue of applying it to mahavakyas? There is no technicality there per se. Something which we already do is done in, you know, it is done with an explanatory note as to why it is being done, because there are objections. However, in Laukika Prayoga, we don't have such objections. We take it for granted. So that is the idea of the Tippanakara here. Atra pitru shabda shakyartha bhuta jamatru janakasya jamatru pitruvena saha, sorry, pitruvena saha sahodaratva sambandho asti. So the jamatu pita, jamatu is the groom, their son-in-law actually. In Hindi they say jamai. So jamatru pita and the one who is the laksharatha, what is the sambandha there? Sahodara sambandha. So they shared the same womb, meaning brother, sahodara. Saha sambandha eva lakshana, and that sambandha is lakshana. So we have to know, when we say lakshana, what is the real meaning of the word lakshana? That sambandha is lakshana. Just like shakti is lakshana, similarly sambandha is lakshana. So when we say I have taken the laksharatha, not the vachyartha, meaning whatever is revealed through shakti, which is also sambandha rupa between pada and padartha, that is not what which I have taken, but having taken that, understanding that it is not the tatparya vishaya, I drop that meaning and use another sambandha with that padartha, that sambandha with another artha of the shakyartha is called as lakshana. Sa sambandha eva lakshana. Taya lakshanaya bodhya pitruvya rupaha artha pitru shabdasya lakshartha. So pitruvya, uncle. So here jamatu pitruvyena sa. The jamatu pitru is what is uttered. But jamatu pitruvya, pitruvya is the uncle, through the sambandha with the jamatu, jamatru pitru. So jamatru pitru and jamatru pitruvya have sahodara sambandha. That sahodara sambandha is lakshana. Taya lakshanaya bodhyaha pitruvya rupaha artha pitru shabdasya lakshartha. So pitru shabda, pita is the shakyartha, pitruvya is the lakshartha through the lakshana. Sahodara rupa sambandha, which is lakshana. Athava kupaschalati iti kaschid braviti tatra kupa shabdasya shakyartha bhuta jalapurna vate chalana kriyayaha asambhava tatra vaktus tatpuryam nasti. Ataha kupa sambandhi balivarda dvaya yukta charma bhastrikaya vaktus tatpuryam tasmat kupa shabdasya shakyartham shakyartham samagram parityajya tatsambandhi balivarda dvaya yukta charma bhastrika grahana jahal lakshana itham eva margo gataha chulli jvalati ityadi vakyeshvapi jahal lakshana bodhya. So some other examples are used which are more difficult than gangayam grosha, because we don't know chulli jvalati margo gataha where it is used, not so conversant with the usage of the Sanskrit language, whereas the story, it can be interpreted in any language, does not have to be Sanskrita itself. So whether you know kupaschalati, at least I don't know of these examples, kupaschalati. So well is moving, the well isn't moving, we are talking about the water which is in another container, that's moving. So maybe some peculiar usage there, these are there in Sanskritam. Now in the Tattvamasi Mahavakya, we'll finish this tippana, at least some parts. Kenachid acharyena siddhante. So this is okay, the story, through that we get what jahati lakshana is. Now this jahati lakshana has been said in Mula as not applicable in the case of Tattvamasi Mahavakya. There jahad ajal lakshana is used. So there bhagatyaga lakshana, where jahati is not applicable, ajahati is not applicable, but bhagatyaga, both jahati ajati, you retain some meaning, give up the other. That kind of lakshana is used. However, some acharya, especially I think in Jivan Mukti Viveka, jahati lakshana has been, not Jivan Mukti Viveka, I think Naishkarmya Siddhi. Bhagavan Sureshwaracharya shows in Naishkarmya Siddhi, if I am not mistaken, that jahati lakshana can also be used to land on Mahavakya Artha. It need not be Bhagatyaga lakshana. However, Siddhanta says it is Bhagatyaga lakshana. We need not get stuck on which lakshana is used, as long as you understand the meaning. The lakshana which is used depends on how much manana has been done on each pada. If one has already landed on the meaning of jiva as sharira rahita atma, sharira traya rahita atma, then based on what is on the other side, the equation has to be resolved. You cannot do jahati ajahati lakshana, jahad ajahad, you cannot put together, because on left side you already dropped it. So when you apply it based on that, what is the tvampada artha in your understanding, what is the tatpada artha in your understanding, based on that you will solve the equation and if the vachyartha itself is different from what is meant in the Upanishad, because you already done manana, you imply tvampada already, then bhagatyaga lakshana may not apply. So it depends on whether you are dealing with Shuddha Chaitanya or you are dealing with Saguna Brahma on the other side and the Jiva with the Upadhitraya on the other side. Based on this, you will apply the Lakshana. So there is a clarification given. Kenachid Acharyena Siddhante Vakshyamana Sthale Api Jaha Lakshana Pradarshita. Some Acharya has done this. I remember this as Bhagavan Sureshwara Acharya has done it at least in one place. Tatha hi sarvam khalvidam brahma iti shrutau sarvasya jagataha brahma rupatvam uchyate. When you say sarvam khalvidam brahma, meaning the mantra is sarvam khalvidam brahma, sarvam khalu idam brahma, idam jagat, sarvam jagat brahma. What kind of lakshana should be used in that case? Earlier I mentioned there it is bada samanadi karanyam. Where the bada of nama rupatmaka jagat is done and then you land on brahma, which is Sachidananda. Brahma does not have nama rupa. If it is nirguna brahma, if it is saguna brahma, then we say nama rupa and then asti bhati priya. When you say jagat, jagat itself is nama rupatmakam. However, if you understand jagat as nama rupa asti bhati priya, Sachidananda plus nama rupa, then you will do bhagatyaga lakshana. On both sides, if you have nama rupa, then you will do bhagatyaga lakshana. If on one side you have nama rupa, on other side you don't have nama rupa, then you will do jagati lakshana. Or on one pada you will do bhagatyaga lakshana, on other pada you don't have lakshana, you will take the vachyartha. So the mechanism depends on what is the vachyartha of Brahma Shabda and what is the vachyartha of the idam pada sarvam idam. Tatra anityatva drishyatva vikaritva jadatva dukkhitvadi viparita dharma vishishta namarupatmakan jagat nitya drigrupa avikari chetana आनंदाद्यात्मकं ब्रह्म एव इति उक्तिर विरुध्यते. There is a शक्यार्थ विरोध because one pada talks about सर्वमिदं which is जगत. What kind of जगत? अनित्य दृश्य which is दृश्य अनित्य विकारी जड़ा and दुखरूप. That kind of jagat and adipadena, everything else can be added on there. Whatever we know about jagat, all that can be added. This is contradictory to Brahma Shabda. Viparita dharma vishishta. Jagat is anitya, whereas Brahma is nitya. Jagat is drishya, Brahma is drik, sakshi. जगत इज विकारी, ब्रह्म इज अविकारी. जगत इज जड़ा, ब्रह्म इज चेतना. जगत इज दुख रूप, ब्रह्म इज आनंद स्वरूप. सो ऑन ऑल लेवल्स देयर इज कॉन्ट्राडिक्शन. देयर बाय शक्यार्थ कैनॉट बी पॉसिबल एज द तात्पर्य विषय. नहीं तत्र श्रुतिवाक्यस्य तात्पर्यं संभवति, किंतु बाधायां सामानादिकरणमिति रीत्या नाम रूपात्मक जगत बाधित्वा विशिष्टं तत्संबंधी भूतं यद अधिष्ठान चैतन्यम तदेव ब्रह्म इति श्रुति वाक्य तात्पर्यम. सो व्हेन श्रुति सेज दैट जगत इज ब्रह्म, देन देयर इज बाध सामानाधिकरण. यू हैव टू गिव अप द नाम रूपात्मक प्रपंच. इफ यू नो जगत एज नाम रूपात्मक विदाउट द सच्चिदानंद यू ऑलरेडी एनालाइज परीक्ष लोकान इत्यादि, देन What kind of lakshana will you do? Direct meaning is not possible. Nama rupa cannot be Sachidananda. Thereby, jahati lakshana has to be used. Thereby, bada samanadikaram. You have to drop the meaning of jagat completely. Nama rupatmaka. Tasmad atra sarvam iti padasya vachya bhuta nama rupatmakam jagat sarvam vihaya तत्संबंधी अस्थिभाति प्रियात्मक अधिष्ठानमेव ब्रह्मरूपत्वेन ग्राह्यम्। देन व्हाट इज रिमेनिंग इज इफ यू रिमूव नाम रूप फ्रॉम जगत नथिंग रिमेन्स, अधिष्ठान रिमेन्स, कल्पित नथिंग रिमेन्स। Therefore, you give up that meaning and then related to that you take the Satchidananda Tattva, without which there cannot be Nama and Rupa also. Kalpana cannot be there without the Adhisthana. So, Adhisthana, which is missing in the Jagat really. In the Jagat, Pratitir, Adhisthana is not known at all. What is known is Nama and Rupa. So, you have to drop the complete meaning of Jagat as Nama Rupatmaka Jagat and then जहति लक्षण थ्रू संबंध यू हैव टू यूज द अधिष्ठान। अधिष्ठान संबंध इज देयर, दैट अधिष्ठान संबंध दैट इज द लक्षण एंड थ्रू लक्षण जहति लक्षण यू हैव लैंडेड ऑन सच्चिदानंद ब्रह्म। तस्मात् जहल लक्षण अत्र आरोपित नाम रूपात्मक जगत स्वाधिष्ठान चैतन्येन सह यस्तादात्म्य संबंध सा लक्षण। दैट तादात्म्य संबंध विद द अधिष्ठान विच इटसेल्फ अपीयर्स एज नाम रूपात्मक प्रपंच, that is the lakshana here. Taya lakshanaya jnapyamanam adhisthana chaitanyam lakshartha. So the lakshartha, the implied meaning is the adhisthana chaitanya. However, now this is only kenachid, but there are multiple tikakaras also who take in this case of sarvam khalvidam brahma, they take badhayam samanadikaranyam. Now interestingly, in Tattvamasi also there is some acharyas who have taken badhayam samanadikaranam, because jiva depends on what you understand by jiva. So lakshana, generally how it is explained is that the simplest way to explain is bhagatyaga lakshana. However, it depends on the sadhaka, which prakriya is using, what is his understanding of the pada leading to padartha shakyartha on each side. So it is very particular. We have to know all lakshanas to understand which lakshana to use in which case. If you take the standard meaning of the padas as explained in the Shruti, then it is bhagatyaga lakshana. In the case of Tattvamasi Mahavakya, in the case of Aham Brahmasmi, what is the understanding of Aham? Even in the case of Shvetaketu, if you take bhagatyaga lakshana initially is what is applied. Once he lands on the meaning of each pada, when he hears the teaching Tattvamasi Mahavakya, when it is said He Shvetaketo Tat Tvam Asi, in each repetition it is not the same meaning which has been talked about there. Lakshana varies there also, because his understanding of Tvam Padartha is changing with each example given in each section of repetition of the mantra. So 9 times when it is repeated, his understanding of tvam pada has changed, his understanding of tat pada has changed. We don't know what exactly changed, different acharyas will talk about it differently. Based on what his understanding is about tat pada and tvam pada, because both need not be understood at the same time. Both may not be understood at the same time, at the same stage, both meanings may not have reach the same granularity. So you may not have Tvampada Upadhis and Tatpada Upadhis same at same time. They may vary at different times. The granularity changes. One may be analyzing, doing manana on Tatpada a lot, thereby some meaning one may land on. At other times one may analyze Tvampada and land on Tvampada meaning. So thereby, when one is analyzing that equation to land on the aikya, one may use different lakshanas. Thereby, we should not fault any acharya for using any lakshana in particular case, because we do not understand where the acharya is coming from. Jahati lakshana may be valid, jahadaja lakshana may be valid, based on where the sadhaka is, what is the analysis being done. Now, if you say Jahadaja Lakshana or Bhagatyaga Lakshana alone should be used, everything else is nonsense. There are some people who say that. They have not understood where the Acharya is coming from. If the definition of jagat is nama rupatmakam jagat, where do you get this bhagatyaga lakshana on the pada? What will you do bhagatyaga of nama? If you give up nama, rupa will be there. Rupa cannot be equated with Sachidananda. Are you going to equate nama with Sachidananda by dropping rupa? That also you cannot do. Then you have to drop the nama rupa completely, because that is all that is there. The definition of jagat is nama rupatmakam prapancha. So when that jagat definition has not been understood, then one can point out flaws in the acharya, saying that jagati lakshana should not be used. But if he has understood, then he cannot say that jagati lakshana is not valid. So when it is said mukhya siddhante, it is generally when it is used to explain the masses. It is not something which is applicable in each and every case. So we should have that viveka. Nobody can fault any sampradaya acharya, because they have landed on the siddhanta through the sampradaya itself. All we can say is that we don't know this prakriya, or I don't understand this prakriya, I have not used this prakriya. This is all we can say. That it is not valid is a statement that no one can make, unless there is a fault with the application. Padartha itself is wrongly analyzed. So typos and other cases are different, but if we have understood the prakriya, then we have to take it to conclusion and see the possibility there. Sambhavana should be analyzed. So mukhya siddhante tu atra bhagatyaga lakshana angi kriyate. Bhagatyaga lakshana is used generally. Antarena adhisthana jnanam arupita pratitir na jayeta. Now why in this case also he says that bhagatyaga lakshana should be used? He says nama rupatmaka prapancha cannot be known separately without the adhisthana jnana. Now this is a nayayika's principle. You cannot know something which is a guna ityadi. So guna, dharma, jati, all this cannot be known unless the adhisthana on which it rests is known. So you cannot know some quality of something without knowing that something as an adhisthana. In other words, in our Rajju Sarpa example, this sarpatva that we are analyzing or having pratiti of, that sarpatva pratiti cannot be there without the idam adhisthana. So when we say this is a snake, that thisness does not belong to sarpa, thisness belongs to the adhisthana. So adhisthana cognition is there, however not completely. Thereby Sachidananda tattva cannot be not known, and then nama rupatmakam jagat being known. So what is being said is that this is technical now. So technically you can say that, oh, without the adhisthana you cannot have this guna jnana, or you cannot know nama and rupa without the adhisthana. However, adhisthana is lost on the person who is analyzing jagat, or he has already discarded the nama rupa, or he has already misunderstood nama rupa as being there, because the adhisthana is mixed up there. So in analysis, one is looking at only nama rupa. There it is possible. The refutation is technical. Therefore, mukhya siddhante tu atra bhagatyaga lakshana angi kriyate antarena adhisthana jnanam arupita pratitir na jayeta. So arupita cannot be known unless the adhisthana is known somewhat. That somewhat is there. Adhisthana avyatirekena eva arupitam pratiyate. So what is arupita? Arupita is nothing but adhisthana itself really. What is seen is the adhisthana itself in a different way. Tasmad astibhati priyatmakam nama rupam evacha sarva shabdasya va idam shabdasya va vachyartha. So vachyartha is not nama rupa. If it is nama rupa, then jagati lakshana. If vachyartha itself is nama rupa and astibhati priya, then tatra nama rupamsham vihaya avasishta astibhati priyatmaka adhisthana amshaha yaha tadeva brahma. Thereby bhagatyaga lakshana, because you have dropped nama rupa but you have held on to astibhati priya. Thereby in Sarvam Khalvedam Brahma, where Sarvam does not mean Namarupa, but it means Namarupa Astibhati Priya Der Bhagatyaga Lakshana. Itam Sarvam Khalvedam Brahma iti Vakyasthe Sarva Pade Idam Padeva Bhagatyaga Lakshana Angi Kriyate. So this is the Mukhya Siddhanta. Now going on to Aja Lakshana in the Mula. अत्र वाच्यस्य समग्रतया परित्यक्तत्वात् जह लक्षणा इयम्. सो जह लक्षणा वी हैव सीन. नाउ अज लक्षणा. व्हाट इज अज लक्षणा? वाच्यार्थेन सह एव वाच्य संबंधी ज्ञानं येन पदेन जायते तत्पदे तस्मिन्नर्थे अज लक्षणा ग्राह्या. सो वाच्यार्थेन सह, व्हाटएवर इज द डायरेक्ट मीनिंग अलोंग विद दैट, वाच्य संबंधी ज्ञानं येन पदेन जायते तत्पदे अस्मिन् अर्थे अजल लक्षण ग्राह्य. अलोंग विद दैट, इफ देयर इज समथिंग एल्स नोन दैट वाच्य संबंधी ज्ञान इज देयर, सम रिलेशन इज आल्सो नोन थ्रू अ पद. सो व्हेन आई अटर समथिंग देन दैट पदार्थ इज नोन विच इज शक्यार्थ. अलोंग विद दैट समथिंग एल्स आल्सो कम्स टू माइंड तत्पदे तस्मिन् अर्थे अजल लक्षणा ग्राह्य. देन होल्डिंग ऑन टू द रिवील्ड मीनिंग, डायरेक्टली रिवील्ड मीनिंग एंड अनदर विच कम्स अलॉन्ग विद दैट, एन आइडिया दैट कम्स टू माइंड दैट ऑल्सो बींग एडेड एज द मीनिंग ऑफ द वर्ड इज अजल लक्षणा. सो यू रिटेन द डायरेक्ट मीनिंग एंड यू एड द इनडायरेक्ट मीनिंग ऑल्सो टू दैट. एग्जाम्पल शोणो धावती. सो शोणो धावती, सम कलर्ड, so red colored, somebody is running. What is that somebody or something? So that idea comes to mind. So if you say, you know, the right, shweto dhavati, rakto dhavati, so the red or the white or whatever is running. So the color is mentioned, which is a visheshana. What is the vishesha there? Based on the context, you know, if it is a horse race, you know horse. If you are looking at cows running, some cows are standing and another cow is running. One cow starts running. Then the visheshana is said to be running. The visheshana cannot run. The visheshana is in visheshya. So visheshya is running. That visheshya is the implied meaning along with the visheshana. So visheshana applies. The cow is running or the horse is running. Ashva dhavati. Here you have pullinga. So let's use that. Shono dhavati, rakta dhavati, shveto dhavati. There, when you say the red is running, you know that it is a horse. The horse is running. But there are many horses. Which horse is running? The red horse is running. So when you say the red is running, red has to be retained. You cannot just say horse is running because there are many horses. It will not make sense, make complete sense. Just like rakto dhavati, shono dhavati does not make complete sense unless you bring in something in your understanding. It may not be uttered, but the understanding is the red horse is running. So ityatra shona padasya shona varna visishtashve ajahal lakshana. There is ajahal lakshana which leads to which laksharatha? Shona varna visishta ashvaha. The horse which has the visheshana of or qualified by shona color. Shona iti varnaha. We know shona is a color. सो तस्मिन् केवले वर्णे धावनं न संभवति. जस्ट द कलर कैन नॉट रन. अतः शोणपद वाच्यार्थभूत रक्तवर्ण विशिष्टाश्वे शोणपदस्य अजहल लक्षण. देयरफॉर दैट रेडनेस इज नॉट रनिंग, द रेड हॉर्स इज रनिंग, द रेड इज करेक्टेड टू द अश्व हॉर्स विद द विशेषण विशेष संबंध. दैट विशेषण विशेष संबंध इज द लक्षणा हियर अजहल लक्षणा. गुण गुणीनो हो तादात्म्य संबंध उक्तः. शोणो वर्ण विशेषत्वात् गुणः. अतः शोण पद वाच्य रक्त गुणस्य श्वाश्रेण गुणीना अश्वेन सह यह तादात्म्य संबंध सा लक्षणा. सो देयर इज अ गुण गुणी संबंध. विशेषण विशेष्य हियर इज गुण एंड गुणी संबंध. The guni ashwa has which guna? Has rakta guna or shodha guna. Thereby, through that sambandha, you know the implied meaning. Thereby, vachyartham aparityajya eva adhikaamshasya grahanad ajal lakshana yam. This is ajal lakshana because the main meaning has not been dropped. Without dropping the main meaning, another meaning has been added. So, ajal lakshana, udharana is given. Ajal lakshanayaha udharanantarani imani. Tippanakara gives more examples there. And this is an example which is quite commonly used as well. Kake bhyo dhadi rakshatam. Iti vakke kaka iti padasya vachyartha bhuta kaka roopa pakshi sakashad dhadi rakshana matrena vaktus tatparyam. So there is a story. The mother is going out and the curd has been freshly made. So this curd has to be protected. It has been set out. Now this curd has to be protected from birds. It is set out outside the house. It has been kept. Now it has to be protected by the child who is at home. So the mother tells the child that protect the curd from the crows. Kake bhyo dadi rakshatam. Now what is the tatparya? The curd should be protected any which way. Not only from the crows, from all sorts of birds. What about if a cat comes in? Obviously it has to be protected from the cat also. But the mother says protect it from crows. Let it be protected from crows. Now this dadhi rakshatam kakebhya, this kaka pada is the direct meaning the pada, the kaka pada vachyartha is the crow. So from the crows, kakebhyo, from the crows dadhi rakshatam kaka pada vachya. So here kintu tatparya, what is it, vaktus tatparya? What is the meaning of the statement there? Vachyartha bhuta kakarupa pakshi sakashat dadhi rakshana matre navaktus tatparyam. The tatparya is not only to protect the dadhi from only the bird crow. However, kintu kakava dadhyupaghata bidaladibhyo api dadhi rakshane vaktus tatparyam. The cat also is included in the word crow. How? Just by looking at the tatparya of protection of the dadhi. Kakapada vachya kakarupa pakshinam bidaladibhi sa dadhyupagata kattvarupam sajatyam asti. There is sajatyam between kaka and dadhi. Kaka and bidala. If you say there is similarity between a crow and cat, there is no similarity. Crow is a bird, cat is not a bird. Where is the similarity? The similarity is looking at the tatparya of protection of curd. The curd needs protection. Can the crow damage the curd? Yes. Can the cat damage the curd? Yes. Therefore, the protection is needed from both. Thereby, similarity is there. That sajatya brings in this lakshana. Soyam sajatya sambandha evat lakshana. So this sajatya sambandha of dadhi upaghatakatva rupa, that is the lakshana here. Thereby ajal lakshana. Atra vachyartha kakam avihaya adhikataya bidaladinam api grahanat ajal lakshana dadyupaghatakaha sarve apyatra kakapadasya lakshyartha. Anything that can damage the curd is the meaning of the word kaka there. How? Implied meaning. So kaka is included, but bidaladi is also included. Then other cases are there. Mancho kroshati ityadi. So there manchak kroshati. I think manchak kroshati is the other example where a bench has been kept. There are people sitting on that or kids are playing. There are many different ways the story is explained. So there is a noise on the stage. So mancha can be a bench or a stage. On the stage there is a lot of noise. So we say the stage is making noise. The stage is not making noise. The kids on the stage are making noise. The word stage does not mean kids or the people on the stage, but there is a sambandha between the stage and the people there. So manchastha manta mancha padavachya khatva roopa artha tasya tadadheya purusheṇa saha adhiyatva sambandha. There is a adhiyatva sambandha, and through that adhiya sambandha you take the indirect meaning, that is the lakshana there. But you cannot drop the mancha shabda artha at all. There mancha sambandha is there. So manchastha purushaha kroshati, that is the meaning there, thereby ajahal lakshana. Then chatrino yanti, the umbrellas are going, the people who are carrying the umbrellas are going. This chatrinaha yanti yashti pravesha ityadi vakyeshu chatri padena yashti padena cha kramena so vachyartha bhutena chatra visishta purushena yashti samudayena cha tat sambandhitaya chatra vihinaha yashti vakascha purusha griyante. So when you say, you know, the statements are there where you don't mean the umbrella or you don't mean the wood. So yashti hi praveshaya. So when you say, you know, you bring let these the wood inside. So, you know, you say you are expecting delivery of some furniture or some wood. So in village side you have these, you know, fuel. Or in temples there is fuel. For fuel you use wood. So get this, you know, let this inside. When you say let these wood inside, what you really mean is the people who are carrying the wood. So yashti samudayena cha tat sambandhitaya chatra vihina yashti vahakascha, yashti vahaka is the meaning there. Those who, so you don't let the wood in, you cannot say you let the wood in and let the people who are carrying the wood stay outside. You cannot have that. So what is meant is that you let the people who are carrying the wood inside. So these are all commonplace. We use this regularly without inquiring into it. But then there is ajah lakshana also, which is commonly used in worldly parlance. Tathachi yatra yatra shruti vakye atma swarupa prati padaka sattva chitvadi visheshanana madhye ekasya va dvayorva upadanam asti tatra tatra anukta anya pita he is extending this to the shruti now. Tatha cha yatra yatra shruti vakya atma swarupa pratipadaka sattva chitvadi visheshanana madhye ekasya va dvayorva upadanam asti tatra tatra anukta अन्य पीतर सर्व विशेषणानि ग्राह्याणि. अन्य अन्य देयर इज अ टाइपो हियर. अन्य अपि शुड बी अन्य अपि. सो आई गॉट अ लिटिल कंफ्यूज एज टू व्हाट इज दिस पीतर. अन्य अपि इतर सर्व. सो और तत्र तत्र अनुक्तानि. सो इट कैन बी अनुक्त. इट्स अनुक्तानि, इट्स नॉट अ कंपाउंड देयर. सो तत्र अनुक्तानि अपि इतर सर्व विशेषणानि ग्राह्याणि. सो सॉरी आई डिड अ रॉन्ग पदच्छेद देयर. सो वेरेवर श्रुति वाक्य हैज आत्मस्वरूप प्रतिपादक सत्व चित्वादि विशेषण. सत्व सत्य इज मेंशन जनरली मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम्स वी सी चैतन्य चैतन्य वी हियर चैतन्य. सो चैतन्य इज मेंशन डज नॉट मीन सत्व एंड आनंद इज मिसिंग. इट शुड बी ब्रॉट बैक. सो सत्व चित्वादि विशेषणानां मध्ये एकस्य वा द्वयोर्वा उपादानम् अस्ति तत्र तत्र अनुक्तानि अपि इतर सर्व विशेषणानि ग्राह्याणि. ऑल दीज विशेषणा विच आर लक्षण विशेषणा दे आर नॉट यूज्ड टू सेपरेट आउट बिकॉज देर इज नो सजातीय विजातीय स्वगत भेद. सो दैट भेदरहित ब्रह्म यू वेर शब्द सच एज द डिफाइनिंग एट्रीब्यूट्स आई मेंशनड एज सत् चित् आनंद. If one or two are mentioned, the others are also included there. Tasmat etadrisha stale siddhante api ajah lakshana upayujyate. So we use this lakshana. We also say that it is, you know, upalakshana. So when you say it is upalakshana for other things, so what is meant is that some lakshana is being used whereby the other things are included, and it is commonplace whether in shastra or outside of shastra. So ajah lakshana we have seen, bhagatyaga lakshana we look at in the next part. सुकनित्यं सुप्रकाशं व्यापकं नामरूप अधिष्ठानं बुद्धे बोध्यं बुद्धेर्दृक्यत्व निर्वापारं सर्ववेदांत वेद्यं प्रत्येक परमः तदेव अन्नमत्तो नित्यं निश्चितामतिः तत्सत् नमस्ते
हरि ओम
नमस्ते।